What a silly intro sequence. Hey guys, so this is only gonna be useful if you really, really want to hoard materials on survival. Alright, so let's say that this is your long-term storage. Using large cargo containers like this one is a good practice because, well, they can store a lot of things. And for most people out there, even for those people who play on multiplayer servers with low PCU limit, they probably have enough PCU to store everything that they need on these containers. Because, well, each of these containers only costs 10 PCU. But, well, let's say that you're such a material hoarder that you need, like, you know, hundreds of cargo containers. Then, you know, you can see how you might start to have a PCU problem. But I have a solution. Let's say that you fill up your cargo container with very useful things. Then, if you remember my PCU optimization video, you know that you can grind down anything until they are below functional. Then you tap the thing again, so that the components got back into the thing. And in this state right now, where something is grind down below functional, no matter what block it is, they will only cost 1 PCU. And well, all of the things that you stored in there will stay in there. So if you want to have like a very large or long-term storage facility, you can store all your stuff in a half grind down container like this one. And if you want to expand your cargo container, you can just add a new one and then you move the connector to this one as well. Then, you know, you repeat the process all over again. So by doing it this way, you can increase the potential cargo storage capacity of your storage facility by 10 folds. Here, just to prove that this trick is indeed working, if you look at my PCU there, you can see that I have 99,244 PCU left. And if I weld this block back up, you guys can see that my PCU has been decreased. Just remember to keep your long-term storage power, which should be easy because you only need, like, you know, a single solar panel and a single battery. So yeah, that's how to build a near infinite capacity long-term storage on Space Engineers without, you know, having it costing thousands or tens of thousands of PCU. Oh, by the way, you should be able to store the components needed to weld the blocks back up in the block progression itself by tapping on the block after you half grind down the block. Again, you know, watch my PCU saving video to see how it works in details. I really need to balance this rover.